Windows Admin Center is an excellent tool for managing your virtual machines, whether they're running on-premises or in the cloud. Hello, my name is Prasid Arora, and I am a program manager on the Windows Admin Center team. Remote virtual machine management has never been easier with Windows Admin Center and remains a heavy area of investment for the team. For this video, let's focus on on-premises virtual machines, and more specifically, the Virtual Machines tool. Hyper-V, or the Virtual Machines tool, is the most used tool in Windows Admin Center, and we've added a whole bunch of new features in version 2009, released in September 2020.
So let's get right to it. Here I have a two-node cluster, and I want to show you the value and elegance we have brought and added with Windows Admin Center. This is a two-node cluster with 8 total drives, 37 virtual machines, 19 of them are running. So even with two nodes, you can just see how powerful you can deliver an HCI system. And Admin Center makes it easy and elegant to manage. I can see, for example, my cluster performance over the course of an hour, over the course of a day, over the course of a week, giving me quick insight into the performance of my system. Of course, let's focus on the Virtual Machine tool. The Virtual Machine tool in Windows Admin Center includes high-level Hyper-V host resource monitoring. Again, I have 18 virtual machines running, 6 that are turned off, and 13 that are saved. And I can immediately see which of these are taking the most amount of memory, most amount of CPU. I can see I/O performance metrics, virtual machine health alerts, and events for the Hyper-V host server or the entire cluster as we have here in a single dashboard. And of course, I'm going to be spending most of my time looking at the inventory page. Admin Center brings a unified experience, bringing Hyper-V Manager and Failover Cluster Manager capabilities together into one place. I can view all of the virtual machines across a cluster, and if I want, drill down into single virtual machines or single servers for more advanced management and troubleshooting. We've designed simplified yet powerful workflows for virtual machine management and new UI experiences tailored to IT administration scenarios to create, manage, and replicate virtual machines. This specific video will go through the end-to-end process of creating and managing a singular virtual machine using Windows Admin Center. I'll touch on some of our already existing features, which will be needed to create this VM, and some of our brand new features that come with this new release of Admin Center, version 2009. I'm going to start with just creating a new virtual machine. For those of you that have created a VM in Admin Center in the past, you'll notice that there's this new navigation bar. We realized that as we kept growing our management tools, searching through this list got very cumbersome. So we did some research and grouped these tasks accordingly. You'll now be able to create a new VM under the Add group, and let's just call it Demo VM. Make it a Gen 2 VM, and I'll create it on the data on node 2. For the purposes of this demo, I'm going to set this to some random path where none of my other VMs are saved. I'll give it 4 gigs of memory and connect it to one of my virtual switches. I'll add some storage. I can let Admin Center create an empty VHD and attach an ISO to it. Or in this case, I have a VHDX file with Windows Admin Center 2019, or sorry, with Windows Server 2019 running on it. With this long list of virtual machines, it really becomes increasingly difficult to find VMs. So Admin Center has made tagging your VMs a very easy task. In this case, I've already defined a variety of tags or categories based on the operating system of my VM. So I'll add WS 2019 to this virtual machine since joining 2019, and filter down my list to only virtual machines with that tag. Of course, I can mix and match tags to make it even easier to find these VMs. With this filtered down list, I can easily find this new demo VM that we just created together. And since this is a brand new server, I'll have to power it on and have to set up the out-of-the-box experience. Although you could RDP into your server or RDP into your VM to do so, there's actually no need to leave Windows Admin Center at all. With the Connect experience, you can VM connect to your virtual machine right from within your browser and go through the out-of-the-box experience that way. So I'll speed this part a little bit. Now with this VM, I picked a Windows Server 2019 data center with a GUI, but this could easily be a core VM thus making some of those basic VM and OS management tasks a little harder, even with this VM Connect experience. So I'll go back to our inventory page and perform a lot of the tasks that IT admins would need to do to set up a VM right from the VM tool or the inventory page of Windows Admin Center. I'll start with monitoring. Clicking on the hyperlink of this VM brings you to a detailed page showing you a lot more information about your VM in a single pane of glass. You can see this page to, or use this page to manage your checkpoints, administer the VHDs, networks, servers associated with this VM, as well as track the performance from the last hour, day, week, month, or year. Of course, this VM was just created, so we can only really see information from the last hour. Now let's go back to our inventory page and go through some of the more interesting features part of Admin Center. Under Manage, I will see the Move command, giving me the ability to live migrate the entire VM or just its storage to another location, bringing no downtime to the VM itself. Admin Center brings in the capabilities of Hyper-V Manager or Failover Cluster Manager, but actually goes beyond both of these tools without even requiring you to switch between two individual tools. Along with migrating your cluster, Admin Center brings you capabilities to migrate this VM to any other server or cluster managed in Windows Admin Center and vice versa. For this demo, I'm going to live migrate to another node in this cluster. And I'm going to pick a random path here once again. And within just a few button clicks, our demo virtual machine has migrated to another node. And after many user requests, Admin Center version 2009 also brings in the functionality to perform live storage migrations, truly lighting up some of these end-to-end scenarios for managing VMs in Admin Center. Just as Hyper-V or Failover Cluster Manager did, live storage migration in Admin Center allows for redistributing due to new storage capabilities, defragmenting VM storage space, migrating from a local storage to a network storage, and many other capabilities that are common to IT administrators. This task takes just a few button clicks in Admin Center, whether you're moving all your storage to one location or splitting it across various locations. In this case, I'm going to move all my storage to where all my other VMs are stored, since I didn't do that in the first place when creating a VM. And I'll click Move. And I can click into my notification bar to see the progress. And after just a little bit of time, it'll complete. So next, in Admin Center version 2009, we bring in some new capabilities to managing the operating system of your virtual machine. Let's start with giving many people access to your VM by joining a domain. Under the Manage tab, you will see a new button to join your virtual machine to a new domain. Normally, this task would require me to RDP or VM Connect and navigate to the computer settings to join the domain and give other users in the domain access to this VM. Not anymore. By entering your domain and some credentials, Admin Center will join your running virtual machine to a domain, making it even easier to manage. Of course, this requires a restart, which Admin Center will take care of for you too. While this virtual machine propagates throughout the Microsoft Redmond domain, I would like to highlight some of the most valued features of managing VMs, which are all hidden really under the Settings tab. The settings give you granular control over memory, disks, networks, and much more of your VM. And we're working to bring in a lot of the important features from Hyper-V Manager into this page. For example, I can go into disks and add a new VHD, or make sure that my live storage migration was indeed successful and it's in that new location. And it was. Here, I'll just change the memory of the memory assigned to this VM to 5 GB. So going back to our inventory page, I'm actually excited to talk about this new feature that gives you power to manage the OS of your VM using standard Windows Admin Center tools. Under Connect, as we saw before, users have the ability to connect in browser or download an RDP file. But something that really blurs the differences between the OS is whether it's with or without a GUI. You're now able to manage your VM using standard Admin Center tools right from within the inventory page, truly bringing in that complete granular management, configuration, troubleshooting, and maintenance functionality to your VMs running on-prem. as you can see, the VM is joined to the Redmond domain, just like we did. And I have all of these bread and butter admin center tools at my disposal. I'm able to see the expired certificates for this VM, or here navigate to the local users and groups tool and add my own domain account as an administrator to this machine. So let's hop back into the virtual machine inventory page, and I want to demo one last feature that was released in version 2007 and is just so powerful. I really had to show it to all of you again today. Virtual machine cloning. In the past, cloning a virtual machine using Hyper-V Manager really required over an hour of active grueling work from setting up checkpoints, sys prepping your virtual machine, exporting it, re-importing it back in, deleting any excess files. And Admin Center really simplifies this entire experience to just a few clicks. Here, I'm able to give a new name, select a location, provide some credentials, and that's it. I can choose to sysprep the VM myself or ask Admin Center to sysprep it for me. And I can go get a cup of coffee while Admin Center clones this virtual machine for me. And in the background, it is doing exactly what you would expect. It's sysprepping it, exporting it, importing it. And I'm going to skip a little bit here, but in just under 10 minutes, you will have a new cloned ready, a new cloned VM ready. Folks, that's all the demos I have for you today. Download the newest version of Windows Admin Center today, version 2009, at aka.ms/downloadwac. Also, please take a look at these additional videos about managing Azure Stack HCI using Admin Center, and a very special sneak peek that's in private preview of using Windows Admin Center right in the Azure portal. Thanks, everyone.